text editor is a built-in tool that allows users to format text and add multimedia elements to your Moodle courses. You'll notice the text editor appears most places where you can edit text, including when adding a new activity, updating section descriptions, within text and media areas, and also when adding quiz questions. The text editor has a range of features that are similar to word processors, including the ability to format text, create lists, insert images, tables, and links, and embed videos. The text editor that you see here is the default editor called Atto, A-T-T-O. I will show you how you can switch your preferred text editor a bit later in this video. So to find the text editor, it's going to appear anywhere that you can edit text. One of the most common places that you'll see this is when you add an activity or resource and choose Text and Media Area. This allows you to add text or any of those multimedia elements right on your course page. So we'll demonstrate some of the various features in the Atto toolbar right now. You'll see that the Atto toolbar is this gray bar right here at the top, and you can expand it by clicking this Show More Buttons button. That shows you some advanced features. You can add text just by typing, and then you can edit the text with some of the options here. It's similar to Microsoft Word and a lot of other word processors, where you can choose the paragraph style to make it a heading or paragraph text. You can update the size here. You can edit text itself by making it bold, italics, or underlined, strike through, or adding sub or superscript characters. You can also change the color here. You can also turn items into bulleted or numbered lists by clicking these buttons. You can add links. If you highlight some text and click the link button here, you can paste a URL to link to it. You can also unlink something or prevent auto-linking by clicking these buttons. You can also add emojis here by clicking whichever one you like to insert that. You can also add images, audio, video, or files here. To add an image, you're just going to click this button here to insert or edit image. I've already got one here, but you'll see an option to browse repositories to find the file on your computer. You can click Choose File. Once you do, you'll be brought to this page where you can describe the image with alt text. That's important for individuals who are using screen readers or who may be visually impaired. You'll want to give a quick description of the image itself. You can also adjust some of the paragraph indentation and paragraph settings, whether it's aligned left, right, or center. There's also options to add equations, special characters, tables, formatting, and then checking for accessibility and screenwriting abilities. You can also edit the HTML within your Moodle text editor here by clicking HTML, and it'll show you all of the HTML code. You'd only need to do that if you want to do something advanced, but that's where that option is. Once you're done editing the text, we'll just go and click Save and Return to Course. And now you can see the text that we've just added in the image as well. You can also change your preferred text editor in Moodle. Changing the preferred text editor applies to your own user profile, meaning that anytime you edit or create content within Moodle, it will use whichever editor you've selected. To change the text editor used by your profile, click your profile icon in the top right of the course, and then click Preferences. Under the User Account section, locate Editor Preferences and click that link. So this brings you to the option to change the editor. The one that we've demonstrated in this video, the default editor, is the Atto HTML editor. Clicking either default or Atto will bring you to that one. You can also use TinyMCE. So TinyMCE has some additional functionality, including the ability to more easily create and edit tables. So if you have a lot of tables that you're working with, you might consider using the TinyMCE editor. Please note, there's also a legacy version of TinyMCE, which is simply the older version. But the newer version of TinyMCE is another good choice within your course. So if we jump back to our spot where we saw a text editor, you'll now see that it's using the TinyMCE editor. And you'll notice that because it says Tiny here at the bottom and the toolbar looks different. If we wanted to add an image or adjust some fonts or text, we could do that here. You'll also see some additional options within the menu items here. Table is one that's a little bit easier, and this looks similar to Microsoft Word. So it allows you the ability to edit tables more easily. So that's all for this video explaining how to use the different text editors available in Moodle. If you have any questions about the different editors or how to use them, please reach out to the Teaching and Learning Innovation Hub.